Good morning, dear students. I hope you are all safe by staying at home. Last session we had seen about the factors affecting the rate of the reaction. Now we are going to see the topics chemical equilibrium and equilibrium in physical change and characteristics of chemical equilibrium and ionic product of water and then pH scale and then the role of pH in our day-to-day life. These are the things we are going to discuss in this session. First, let us see the chemical equilibrium. In a reversible chemical reaction, the rate of the forward reaction and the backward reaction are same. Because when the product is formed, at the same time the product will be converted into reactant. So, the rate of the forward and the backward reaction are the same. When the rate of the backward and the forward reactions are the same, the state is called a chemical equilibrium. So, in a reversible chemical reaction, the rate of the forward reaction and the backward reaction happens, no net change in the rate. That means the rate of the forward reaction is equal to rate of the backward reaction. At the same time, there is no change in the concentration of the reactant as well as the products. When we can say that the chemical equilibrium, the state of chemical equilibrium attained means when the rate of the forward reaction is equal to the rate of the backward reaction, the state is called a equilibrium state. So, equilibrium state is a characteristic properties of a chemical reaction in which no change in the concentration of reactants and the products. This is about a chemical equilibrium. And next, initially when a reversible chemical reaction occurs, initially the rate of the forward reaction, let us consider the decomposition of a calcium carbonate. The forward reaction is decomposition of a calcium carbonate. It decomposes into calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. This is forward reaction. Initially, the concentration of the reactant, this is reactant. For the forward reaction, this is the reactant, these are the products in a forward reaction. So, initially when the reaction starts, the concentration of the reactant will be more and the concentration of the product will be less. So, the rate of the forward reaction increases. As the time goes, the concentration of the reactant decreases and the product increases. As we know, the rate of the reaction is directly proportional to the concentration. So, when the concentration of the product increases, automatically direction of the reaction changes. That means the backward reaction happened. So, calcium oxide combines with the carbon dioxide, it forms a calcium carbonate. Because of the concentration of calcium oxide and the carbon dioxide increases as the time goes. So, when the concentration of the product increases, since the rate of the reaction directly proportional to the concentration, because of the concentration of the product increases, the backward reaction starts. So, this is the example for equilibrium, state of equilibrium. This should be conducted in closed container because carbon dioxide is the gas that will escape. To prevent the escape of carbon dioxide, the reaction should be carried out in a closed container. Next, we are going to see equilibrium in physical change. Let us consider water is taken in a closed vessel. When we are heating the water, it starts to evaporate. So, the water vapor is collected at the top of the vessel. When the water vapor, initially the liquid water, the concentration of the liquid water will be more. As the time goes, the gaseous water vapor, gaseous water will be more as the time goes. When the concentration of gaseous vapor increases, automatically the backward reaction starts to occur. So, this is the physical state because from one change, this is the liquid state, this is the gaseous state. So, the chemical equilibrium occurs in change of physical state also. Next, we are going to see characteristics of chemical equilibrium. First character, in a reversible chemical reaction, rate of forward reaction is equal to rate of a backward reaction, and the absorbable property. Absorbable property means that can be seen. So the absorbable properties like density, concentration, color, etc., there is no change. The absorbable properties like density, concentration, color will not change. That remains as such. And then chemical equilibrium is a dynamic nature, because both forward and backward reaction occur simultaneously, even though it is static in nature externally. Outer appearance is like the reaction got over, but actually the forward and backward reaction can occur simultaneously. So the chemical equilibrium is dynamic nature, because both forward and backward reaction occur simultaneously, even though it appears static externally. And then the volume of phases remains a constant. There is no change in volume. The volume of liquid, how much the volume of liquid will be the same as the gas. So there is no change in the volume of phases. That remains a constant. These are the characteristics of chemical equilibrium. Next we are going to see ionic product of water. We know that pure water is non-conductor of electricity, but precise measurement shows that pure water is also a conductor that will conduct electricity to a little extent. Why this is happening? Why pure water is conducting the electricity to a little extent means because of self-ionization. Self-ionization means when two water molecules react together, one of the water molecule will be decomposed into proton and hydroxyl ion. This is proton, this is hydroxyl ion. One of the water molecule will decompose into proton and hydroxyl ion. This proton will combine with another water molecule, leaving hydroxyl ion. So when the proton combines with another water molecule, what it's formed means hydronium ion. This is called hydronium ion. This is left hydroxyl ion. So when two water molecules react together, it forms hydronium ion. Hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion. So because of the ion formation, there is a conduction of electricity. And then during this formation, when the hydronium ion formed here is called acidic medium, and the hydroxyl ion here formed is called the basic medium. This is highly acidic and this is highly basic. So again they will combine with each other to form the water molecules. So this is a reversible reaction. So both the forward reaction, that means split up into hydronium and hydroxyl ion, is the forward reaction. This combination of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion changed into water again, that is a backward reaction. So both the reactions occur. The water molecule, two water molecules combined together to form hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion, is called self-ionization, because water and water combined together, it forms hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion. So this is self-ionization. The conductivity of water is due to self-ionization. And then what is ionic product of water? We know that this is concentration. When the thing is written in square bracket, the square bracket indicates that concentration. So concentration of hydronium ion, this is concentration of a hydroxyl ion. In between, what mathematical operation is there, that is a multiply. So the multiplication symbol will be defined in another form, that is a product. Product of a concentration of hydronium ion and hydroxyl ion, concentration of hydroxyl ion, that is called the ionic product of water. So what is ionic product of water means the product of concentration of hydronium ion and concentration of hydroxyl ion, that is ionic product of water. Instead of hydronium ion, we can write hydrogen ion concentration also. So instead of hydronium ion, we are writing H plus, because both are same. So the product of a hydrogen ion concentration with concentration of hydroxyion, that is called the ionic product of water. Its unit is mole square dm power minus 6. Its value is 1 into 10 to the power minus 14. And next we are going to see pH. All the aqueous solutions contains hydrogen ion and hydroxyl ion. That is responsible for the conduction of electricity and because of a self ionization. When the substance is dissolved in water, it forms hydrogen ion concentration. It forms more hydrogen ion, means that is called acidic. When the substance is dissolved in water, it forms more hydroxyl ion, means that is called base. The pH range starts from 1 to 14, 1 to 7, 1 to, if the pH range is 1 to 6.9, means that is acidic. When the pH is 7, means that is neutral. More than 7, it is basic. The term is introduced by the scientist Sorensen in 1909. And next we are going to see how to test pH and what is the mathematical expression of a pH. pH is the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. So what is pH? pH means negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. This is hydrogen ion, square bracket indicates concentration. So what is pH? pH is defined as the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. That is the definition for pH. And already I told the pH range from 1 to 6.9, that is acidic. 7 is neutral. If the pH is 7, means that is neutral. If the pH is more than 7, means that is basic in nature. And in our book, the tabular column is given. And some of the acids and some of the substances are given, and their pH range is also given. Next, we are going to see how the pH range, pH is tested. We have solution for testing the pH, or pH strips are there. When we are dropping the liquid on the pH strip, by observing the color change in the slip, we can identify whether the solution is acidic, basic or neutral, because the bands are given, different color bands are given. Depends upon the color change occurred for the particular solution, we can identify whether the given solution is acidic or basic in nature. Next, we are going to see how the pH range is affecting, how the role of pH range in our day-to-day life. The human body, the pH range of human body, normal human body ranges from 7.0 to 7.8. All the living organisms pH range falls within the narrow range. And then the human blood, the pH range is 7.35 to 7.45. The pH range of ideal blood, that means the perfect blood, the pH range of ideal blood is 7.4. If there is any increase or decrease in the pH range, means it leads to diseases. And then next we are going to see digestive system. In our stomach, one fluid is secreted, that is hydrochloric acid, that is acidic in nature. The pH range of hydrochloric acid secreted in our stomach is 2. That helps in, the hydrochloric acid secreted in our stomach helps to digest the food. During indigestion, our stomach secretes more hydrochloric acid. So we will be getting burning effect. Sometimes it leads to ulcer also. So we have to maintain the pH range in our digestive system also. Next, tooth decay. Our tooth is made up of enamel coat, phosphorus and calcium carbonate. The pH range of a human saliva is 6.5 to 7.5. If it falls, the human saliva pH range falls below 5.5, means definitely the weathering can happen in the enamel, so we'll be getting the sensitivity in our tooth. So to reduce that, we have to maintain the pH range of saliva, we have to use basic toothpaste. The toothpaste must be basic in nature. And then soil. Soil also should contain some extent of pH range. For example, citrus fruits needs alkaline soil. Alkaline soil means a basic soil. Citrus fruits needs basic soil, and rice needs acidic soil, whereas sugarcane needs neutral soil. And then the pH range of rainwater is 7, because that is neutral. The pH range of rainwater is 7. That is neutral in nature, where because of the liberation of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, and then carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, the pH range of rainwater changes, because the rainwater changed into acidic in nature. If the pH range falls below 7 because of this oxides, then we can say that is acid rain. Now we are going to see the problems regarding pH. First problem, they are asking you to find out pH. The substance given is acid, nitric acid, and then so nitric acid means the given concentration is hydrogen ion concentration. Because this is acid, acid contains only hydrogen ion, so hydrogen ion concentration is given. So what is the mathematical expression for pH? Means negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. Here the hydrogen ion concentration is 0.01, so it is given there. So we can convert this into 10 to the power. So 0.01 means after decimal 2 digits are there, therefore 1 by 100, we can write as 10 to the power minus 2. 1 by 100, the value of this is 1 by 100, we can convert this into 10 to the power minus 2. So how to find out minus log? Instead of hydrogen ion concentration, I am going to write 1 into 10 to the power minus 2. So when we are taking logarithm for 1, for the base 10, the value is 0. For the finding the log of 10 to the power minus 2, we will be getting minus 2. Therefore, minus log 1 base 10 plus, because multiplication is there, multiplication means plus, for when we are taking log for two terms. Then next one is log 10 to the power minus 2. The value of log 1 base 10 is 0. Therefore, minus 0, and the power should be brought in front. So, plus into minus, minus, minus 2 log 10 base 10. The value of a log 10 base 10 is 1. Therefore, 0 minus 2 minus 2. Therefore, minus of minus 2, we will be getting 2. So, the pH of a nitric acid is 2. In this problem, the pH of nitric acid is a 2. And then, the second problem, hydroxyl ion concentration is given. They are asking us to find out the pH value by giving the hydroxyl ion concentration. First, we have to find out the POH. What is the mathematical expression of PO, which means negative logarithm of a hydroxyl ion concentration? So, what is the hydroxyl ion concentration given there? 1 into 10 to the power minus 10. So, minus log 1 into 10 to the power minus 10, sorry, minus 9. Directly, I am taking this as minus 9 in front. Therefore, minus of minus is plus 9. So, the POH value is a plus 9. And another term is there, the sum of pH and POH. The sum of pH and POH is a 14. But we have only the POH value, but we have to find out pH value. So, by using the POH, we have to find out pH. So, how to find out pH? pH is equal to 14. This plus POH, when we are bringing that side, it becomes minus. Therefore, 14 minus POH. What is VOH value? We got it from this 9. Therefore, 14 minus 9, we are getting 5. So, the pH value of a given substance is 5. Since it falls within the limit of 7, the given substance is acidic in nature because the pH value is 5. So, the given substance is acidic in nature. Next, hydrogen ion concentration is given. Acid given here is a hydrochloric acid. First, we have to hydrochloric acid, we have to write ionic form H plus plus Cl minus. How many hydrogen ion is there? Only one hydrogen ion. So, the given concentration we have to take as such. And already I told after decimal 3 digits are there. So, 0.001 will be getting 10 to the power minus 3. This we can consider as a 10 to the power minus 3. And what is the pH value? pH is equal to negative logarithm of a hydrogen ion concentration. Here the hydrogen ion concentration is 1 into 10 to the power minus 3. Therefore, minus of minus plus, therefore the pH value is 3. And next problem, sulfuric acid is given. Hydrogen ion concentration given here is 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. First we have to split the sulfuric acid into ions. So how many hydrogen ions are there? 2 hydrogen ions. H2SO4 will split up into 2H plus plus SO4 2 minus. So we have 2 hydrogen ion. But here given only one hydrogen ion concentration, since 2 hydrogen ions are formed, we have to multiply the concentration with a 2. Therefore, for finding 2 hydrogen ion concentration, 2 into 5 into 10 to the power minus 5. We should not multiply the power into 2. Only the whole number we have to multiply. Therefore, 2 into 5, 10. 10 into 10 to the power minus 5. Here it is 1. So, both the base are same. So, we have to add the powers. So, what we are getting means 10 to the power minus 4. So, this is the hydrogen ion concentration. Now, we will go to find out the pH value. pH value is equal to negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. Here, the hydrogen ion concentration is 10 to the power minus 4. 1 into 10 to the power minus 4. Therefore, minus of minus, we will be getting 4. So, the pH value of a sulfuric acid formed here is a 4. And then, sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide is base, so it will split up into sodium ion and hydroxyl ion. So, only one hydroxyl ion formed here, so we can take as such. So, first we should find POH only for this, because hydroxyl ion concentration is given, so we can find only hydroxyl POH only. Therefore, negative logarithm of hydroxyl ion concentration minus log 1 into 10 to the power minus 4, minus of minus will be getting plus 4. So, pH value is 4. pH value is equal to 14 minus POH. Therefore, 14 minus 4, so the pH value is 10. And then hydrogen ion concentration is given as 1 into 10 to the power minus 8. They are asking us to find out the pH value. Directly we can substitute the value, because the acid, the name of the acid is not mentioned there. If it is mentioned there, means we have to split up into ions. For example, sulfuric acid, we have to split up into ions. Here the acid name is not mentioned, so directly we can find out the pH value. What is pH? pH is the negative logarithm of hydrogen ion concentration. So the hydrogen ion concentration is given as 1 into 10 to the power minus 8. Therefore, minus of minus plus. So the pH value is 8. So I think you understood all the problems that I taught in this class. In our book, problems are given there. In page number 154, problems are given there. Just you look at the book. First one, lemon juice has a pH 2. What is the concentration of a hydrogen ion? By seeing the pH value, we can easily calculate the hydrogen ion concentration, 10 to the power minus 2. pH value is T2 means the hydrogen ion concentration is 10 to the power minus 2. That means 0.01. And then calculate pH value for the nitric acid. Nitric acid will split up into hydrogen ion plus nitrate ion. So hydrogen ion, only one hydrogen ion is there. So we need not to multiply the concentration given there with any of the number. We can take as such. By using the pH formula, you can easily calculate the pH value of a nitric acid. And then the third problem, what is the pH of a 1 into 10 to the power minus 4 molar solution of a potassium hydroxide? Potassium hydroxide is given there, therefore the given concentration is a hydroxyl ion concentration. So directly we cannot find out the pH value. First we have to go for finding the POH value. So we have to substitute the formula POH. So POH is the negative logarithm of hydroxyl ion concentration. By after finding the POH, we can find out the pH value. And then the last problem, the hydroxyl ion concentration is given. They are asking us to find out the pH. The same thing we can follow. First we have to find out, because the given concentration is hydroxyl ion concentration, so first we have to find out the POH. By after finding the POH value, easily we can find out the pH value by deducting the POH from 14. So these are the things we had seen in this class. I think you understood all the problems. You worked out the problem from the book in the page number 154.